Now that you've saved a workbook to your OneDrive, you can use Excel Online to open it from any device that has a supported web browser. This includes most recent smartphones, tablet devices, and personal computers. Even if the device doesn't have Excel 2013 installed, you'll be able to view and edit the workbook using the free Excel Online application. If you have a tablet computer, such as an iPad or a recent smartphone, you might find it interesting to use this device rather than your Windows PC for this lesson. So I need to begin by opening a web browser. I'm going to open Internet Explorer. I chose Internet Explorer for a good reason. Even though Excel Online supports Internet Explorer, Chrome, Firefox, and Safari, it's better to use Internet Explorer if it's available. That's because Internet Explorer is a Microsoft product, so you can always expect it to work perfectly with Excel Online. But if you ever find that Excel Online doesn't work with a particular browser, simply try using a different browser. It normally solves the problem. Now that I've opened Internet Explorer, I need to go to the OneDrive website. So I'll enter the URL www.onedrive.com and press the Enter key. As with everything on the web, what you see from now onwards might look different for you. And that's because the web is ever-changing. But this is what you would have seen in June of 2014. I'm now going to click the Sign In button at the top right of the screen. And because I'm already signed in, I go straight to my OneDrive account. If you've not signed in yet, you'll be asked for your username and password at this stage. Next, I'm going to click the Documents folder. If you're using a touch device, you would of course tap the folder with your finger. This takes me to the Excel folder. I click Excel, and there's my Practice folder. I click Practice, and there's the Smartphone Sales Workbook that you saved in Lesson 8.1. I'm now going to open Smartphone Sales using Excel Online. To do that, I'll right-click on Smartphone Sales. If you're using a touchpad device, you normally hold your finger on the pad to simulate a right-click. And notice that, in my case, I have two options, Open in Excel or Open in Excel Online. That's because, on this machine, the Excel desktop application has been installed. In a real-world situation, I'd normally select Open in Excel, since it's available, because the desktop version of Excel has more features and is faster than Excel Online. But for the sake of this lesson, I'm going to open the file using Excel Online, so that you can share the experience of users who don't have Excel installed on their device. So I'll click Open in Excel Online. And you can see that Excel Online looks very much like the desktop Excel application. Most, but not all, of Excel's features are available from the ribbon. Now in my case, the ribbon's expanded, but on your device, you may find that it's collapsed in the first instance. You can expand and collapse the ribbon in exactly the same way you do in the Excel desktop application by double-clicking on any ribbon tab. I'll double-click a tab now to collapse the ribbon, and now I'll double-click to expand the ribbon. If you're using a smartphone or tablet device with a very small screen, you'll probably want to work with the ribbon collapsed most of the time. Now let me discuss a very intriguing feature of Excel Online. Notice that there's no save button. That's because if I enter a value into a cell when working with Excel Online, my change is immediately saved, so there's no need to ever save. We'll be discussing this feature in more depth in Lesson 8.7. But all that remains for this lesson is to close Excel Online, and I do that by closing my web browser. So I'll click my web browser's close button, I'll close all tabs, and you've now completed Lesson 8.5, Open a workbook using Excel Online.